Another day and another push from the Morrison government in the name of protecting Australia's national interests.
We have levels of foreign interference in Australia not seen since World War II. And the university sector is a target.
A Federal Intelligence and Security Committee headed by a vocal Chinese Communist Party critic, Andrew Hastie, will investigate the higher education sector.
You will not crush freedom in this country. You will not sell this country out to foreign powers.
On the agenda, the Chinese government-funded Confucius Institute and the controversial research collaboration project, the Thousand Talents Plan. High-profile incidents targeting academic freedom and freedom of speech will also be looked at.
Remember there was a demonstration and it was out of the blue, popped 20,000 students to protest for China? That was rather a neat piece of work. Or was there something behind it?
A number of witnesses will also be called upon, including UNSW lecturer Elaine Pearson, whose comments on the Hong Kong crackdown were posted, then deleted from social media by her employer. Suspended University of Queensland student Drew Pavlou will also front the inquiry.
No Australian student, no Chinese, Hong Kong or Uyghur, Tibetan student here in Australia should ever go through what I had to go through, facing intimidation, fear, facing expulsion simply for criticising the Chinese government on campus. It should never happen again.
The key here is transparency. For example, whether an academic is paid by another entity.
Ms. Jiang says universities have been backed into a corner, sustained cuts leading the sector to be heavily reliant on international enrolments.
The universities are in a hard place that on the one hand, with the reduced government funding, and on the other hand, the government is targeting their other source of funding.
The inquiry comes amid escalating trade tensions between China and Australia. Beijing today broadening its investigation into Australian wine imports to include alleged Australian government subsidies. It comes just 2 weeks after China launched an anti-dumping probe.
Obviously, we're going to defend this vigorously. We don't subsidise Australian wine industry or the agricultural sector to most of the OECD countries. And in fact, also with respect to dumping, Australian wine is the second highest priced commodity in the Chinese market.
Shubha Krishnan, SBS World News.